this small, what do you call that, training in the control panel. Here have what output is coming with. Right now it's pellet program, it's stopped. And if it runs 100% or 50 or whatever, the output will stand here. You've got the temperature. After the temperature, if you've got a small sign there, it comes, it stays there until you comes under the minimum temperature. Normally, the minimum temperature is set 15 degrees under what you want in temperature. So it means that if you rise your temperature, you must remember that when it comes 15 degrees under, it'll drop out. For more than 10 minutes, it'll drop out and write low temperature as a warning here in the upper. If something, you come out to the boiler system and it's stopped, keep your fingers in your pocket. You will always see what's wrong here in the upper line. Look with the eyes, not with the fingers. See that first before you press the start button. Then O2 auto. That's the O2 level measured in the boiler. Auto means it runs on lambda probe controlled. If there stands manual here, man, it means that the man has shut off O2 regulation and run manually without lambda probe. O2 wanted, it's when the boiler is running. After what output it wants, it writes an O2 what it wants at that point, and it will regulate the stoker pulse, how much the stoker auger runs to get O2 auto and O2 wanted to look like each other after the burn value. Here on the front page you can only look, and when you go down to the setting you can press right like the arrow. You can't, that way it doesn't work, but this way. Here you can set the temperature. There you can choose the fuel type. If you want to change the fuel type, press right like the arrow shows. And then you can choose up and down, grain, wood chips, or other fuel. Grain, wood chips, and wood pellets are set from the factory. Other fuel you can change yourself. If you want to change the factory settings on fuel, you have to go into password 37. If you forget to press the right button when you have changed the fuel, it jumps back to pellet as it was. The right arrow here is safe settings, so to speak. There you calibrate the O2 lambda probe, but only do that after 10 minutes power on the unit, so it's the lambda probe heating element has heated up. And you may not do it when there are any fire or smoke in the boiler. The best is to do when it's a unit that has been running. Take out the lambda probe, make it clean. There are an air hole in the bottom and four on each on the side. Clean them, lie it on top of the boiler, and then calibrate it if it's necessary. In here, O2 regulation on off. See, we press right here. You can go in O2 regulation, yes. Now we can just try to see and change that to no. And save it, O2 regulation no, we go back to the front page, you can see O2 manually instead of O2 auto. It means the man is doing something himself, he has taken over how the controls. It still changes the output from 0 to 100% and regulates the fuel amount after that, but it regulates the fuel amount after what you have set here as a manually factor. The manual factor here, it says that if the boiler is running, we are running around O2 regulation. So now if the boiler is running with 100% output, you'll give it only 35% of what stands in the pellets program. So it means if you run 50% output, you give 50% of 35% of the pellets program. We change it to yes again, so it's auto, so the man, he's off for the week. Other fuel, in here you can change the settings in the other fuel. If you've got some other fuel instead of wood chips, grain, or wood pellets, if it's coffee or whatever, cookies or... Stoker motor menu tells you what power the stoker motor uses. Here we have, and that's the stoker auger. Here it is set to a maximum of 120, it's a value. And when you press the start button, you'll see it counting by power here. And normally it's lying around, on this model here, around a couple of 60 in value here. If it comes over 120, we have said that it must only have one error. Then it'll count one error here and it'll stop, and it'll write stoker motor stop in the front page on the top. The reason why it only may have one error here is because when the stoker motor is running, it has an after run, after the signal that it has run. So if it's stopped, the motor will burn because it's just standing still. So that's what only the one attempt. Fire starter menu, not active. Here we at ash exhale menu, we adjust and say, okay, the ash auger in the bottom of the boiler shall run 2 seconds for every 720 minutes. It depends on from fuel to fuel how much ash you get there. So you'll learn by doing. Blaster menu. When you want to clean the heat exchanger, the pulse comes on for 4 seconds on one of the valves. Open the valve, clean the one side, close again. Then it goes 240 seconds, 6 minutes. It's for having time for the compressor to load up again. Then it shuts off for number two valve, shuts again. Cycle time means that it goes 8 hours before it do the same again. Better to clean often with a low pressure than seldom with a high pressure. And we prefer to 5.5 bar at the compressor, not more. Here we have passwords. We want to go into the menu and change something. All the passwords gives 10 when you add them. It means password 37, 3 plus 7 gives 10. Password 46, 4.6 gives 10. Password 82, 8 plus 2 gives 10. Remember, everything you change under the password, you have to go into password 37. See here. Keep the top bottom in until you come to 37. Stop. Save it with right. Here you can change the factory fuel menu, run menu. If you say run menu and you change your temperature, here you can change what setting you can set the temperature between. And low temperature, it means that 15%, 15 degrees under. You've set 70 degrees on the boiler. It means that the mark at the front page before the temperature will disappear 15 degrees under wanted temperature. So it means by 55 degrees, 56 degrees, that mark disappears. But if you drop 15 degrees under the set temperature for more than 10 minutes, it'll stop and it'll write low temperature. But everything you change in under password, you have to go to factory. It's a password 37, fax service menu, press right, go down into the bottom, and save settings. Here we have one called recall all. It doesn't recall all, but it does recall some of the settings. If we want to make a main recall, we go by this, which is a CS150, go into password 82, change it to a CS250, go back again, change it to a CS150, and it's back to the factory menu again. But then remember, you have to put in again the way in menu on the different fuels and adjust the lambda probe, calibrate it. Here we've got the way in menu where we set in what the feed-in auger on top of the rotary valve gives per minute in kilo on the different fuels. And this post-run, it tells you that when the feeding auger stops, the rotary valve and the bottom auger in the feeding the fuel into the burner tube runs this post-run after. Yeah, that's it.